Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, a Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We've just arrived in Garden Hill. It's another place with multiple levels. It can always be a little tricky. It's wide. It's a wide town. Wow. This is just a bed out in the open. Something tells me this place has seen better days. Come around to the front of the counter. You're not from around here, are you? I admire your guts. How did you climb the canyon on foot? It was pretty tiring, says Evan, but we had those elevators. But do people of Garden Hill always go through such pains to get to other towns? You have our respect. Oh, that's a mutual respect going on here. Haha, that's impossible. In old days, we did go up and down the canyon on foot. But now we have an elevator that takes us from the underground of Garden Hill to the lowest level of the canyon. We use the elevator to go to places in the lower world. Then everyone is speechless. Avon and the company took a deep sigh, remembering the pains they had climbing the canyon. Well, it was good for experience. The direct service elevator is now out of order. I'll fix it by the time you come back. Well, good to know. You sell stuff too? No? Are you just standing there? Alright. I thought he was going to tell us to come around to the front of the counter and stuff. Alright. It's unusual to have customers who are not from around here. Why don't you buy something as a memento of Garden Hill? Why don't I? Hi there. We have useful items in our store. An exorcist charm. Talisman containing anti-magic inside disables enemy ally spells for a while. Huh. That's interesting. Grand helmet. Well, it brings our hit down and stuff, so I don't want to get that. Moon ring. Element anklet. Protective amulet with spiritual power. Reduces the damage by enemy spells. All this stuff doesn't completely help. Mountain food pet food. Pet food made with ingredients from the forest. That sounds interesting. I'll take 3. Hi there. We seldom have travelers here. Our store is located in a remote place, but we are proud of our collection. Please take time to view the products. Well, I already did, unless you're selling stuff too. I don't think you are. How do these people get by with no roof? Elder Rappan says, it's unusual. Not many people travel to a high altitude like this. What brought you here? Avon says, we came here to find a shrine of spirit. Oh, the Idun Shrine. Then you should visit Reithol. Reithol? Says Ratiz. He is an ascetic who protects Idun. As usual, he should be listening to the words of Idun at the shrine today. Avon asked, listening to the words of Idun? It may be hard to believe for people from outside, but here in Garden Hill, we have long been communicating with Idun through ascetics. I'm surprised, says Avon. It's quite different from what they do in Quint. If we can talk to Idun, then we may be able to get the sacred treasure easily. That's great news, says Ratiz. Thank you very much, Elder. We'll go see Reithol at once. By the way, I see you all are a little tired. Would you like to take a rest? Yeah, so much for at once. Let's take a rest first. Please come back anytime if you get tired. The Idun Shrine is located north of the village. It's a beautiful place. Okay. Let's say it would be easy to miss something in here. I don't want to miss anything. Old woman Koppel says, Garden Hill is also called the Garden of Gods. This old crumbling structure was built in the ancient times when gods were still around. Ruti says, it's as old as the Shrine of the Spirit. Garden Hill is located at high altitude, so we don't have any rain at all. That's why the ruins have been preserved in good condition. Jeez, it must get cold up here. To live peacefully in good health by feeling the breaths of gods. That's the way of living for the people of Garden Hill. I always think that they're selling something if they're standing back there. Alright, did... yeah. This is... yeah. Just making sure. Oh, the green-haired boy down there. We fell in the water. And we're repeatedly falling in water. They must be laughing at us. Yuta says, you came from the lower world, didn't you? Then how do you... then do you know an older boy with silver hair? Avon says, an older boy with silver hair? So this guy also climbed the canyon to come here? Yes. I've never seen him before. I wanted to talk to him, the older boy with silver hair, but he disappeared before I knew it. I wonder where he went. Well, I have a feeling we're gonna run into him. Just, it's a must at this point. All right, we've been in here. Oh, weapons. How do I get into the weapon shop? Ye old weapon shoppy. Here it is. Oh, I thought that was a chest. Huh. The damages are less than what they suffered in the lower world, but dangerous monsters also began showing up in this place. You should be well prepared, too. Welcome. We can answer all your needs for weapons and protective gears. Dark Blade? Oh, for Lucius. Or Swear Blade. Alright, let's get the Dark Blade for Lucius. Steel sword with high carbon content. Its Dark Blade is sharp and flexible. Lafar Hammer. Huh. A large metal warhammer used by two hands. A heavy weapon that breaks large rocks. Well, maybe the Silverhead guy can use this. I'll have to remember. A stiletto for Rutis. Used only for piercing and has no blade, favored by assassins. But this is even better, Kukri. Knife with a single curved blade, cuts well without requiring much force. Alright, I'm gonna get her the Kukri then. Alright, see you again. Not if I see you first. Right, so the Dark Blade's a step back from him. That Helios Blade must be really good. There you go. Up to 5. The Dark Blade for Lucius. And the... yeah, we didn't find any better... shields, but we did find the better thing for Mutis, the Kukri. Going up by quite a few points here. 17 points? Yeah. Let's do the exchange thing. Wow, you have over 20,000, and we're about to sell some stuff as well. Sell the Zanzu's Fang. And the Katar. Mutisa's old weapon. Down in this lower area. Nope, I need SP Arcanum 1 though. Nope. Or back in the Grand Canyon. Oh yeah, it's not working. Currently under repair. So when we leave this place, we can just take this express elevator back. Good to know. That's what the guy just told us. By the time we're back here, he'll have it fixed. And I think I'm gonna hold him to that. Yo, we don't need that. We need SP Arcanum 1 now. Okay, that's you. Can't really go there. No! The Arcanums we require. I was gonna like walk through some kind of stream or something. New. I think I've seen everything in this town. Oh, that part of town. Stimulant. It's a step in the right direction. Who lives here? Not home. Do not need. Still do not need. Alright, that's. There's nobody here in this area. Probably the shrine is right up there. Oh, who's that? Loretta says, what should I do? Reithol forgot his lunch. Meelin says, once he starts training, Reithol always forgets to eat. I'm worried. Hi there. Where are you from? Ruti says, we came from Guia. Meelin says, I see. It's unusual for people from the lower world to visit us here. People from the lower world, says Avon. Oh, come on. Everyone's been saying lower world. Now you're just paying attention. Loretta says, don't call our guests like that. Okay. I'm sorry. That's how people in the village call others who come from the foot of the mountain. Avon says, well, given the place you live in, it's understandable that you call the places down the mountain the lower world. By the way, you had a worried look just now. Is anything wrong? As a matter of fact, Reithol forgot to bring his lunch. He's training not far from here, so we can bring it to him if we want to. However, Loretta says, monsters have been showing up along the northern road lately. Nobody other than Reithol can take the road. Really? Says Lucius. Reithol must be a skilled guy. Is that the silver-haired guy? Yes, he is very strong, Meelin says. He can take down monsters with his bare hands, and he can also use spells. That's why he's protecting the Idun Shrine. Can we deliver the lunch to him? Asks Avon. We were going to the Idun Shrine anyway. That's great, says Malin. It's perfect. Please deliver it to him. Avon received lunch. I hope we didn't impose, says Loretta. Lucia says, we're adventurers. No average monsters can beat us. What about above average monsters? Don't worry and leave it to us. Okay then, says Loretta. Thank you for your help. Malin says, say hello to Reithol. Bye. And we are left with our thoughts. Lunch. Lunch delivered to Reithol the Ascetic. They spelled it wrong here. Potato croquettes and vegetable pilaf. Well, that sounds delicious. I'm down. I'm eating Reithol's lunch. Sorry, Reithol. And so we're back on the road. I figured this would just bring us... Follower's Path. I figured we'd go right to the shrine from there. Those dragons. Dragon A. Dragon B. I went through that dragon to hit the other one. Dragon remains. No, it doesn't. Not too much XP, but there were only two monsters. What's up there? That's the way we're going? Yeah. Oh, wow, they're fast. Oh, we got the canyon bat now, too. One dragon. One down. Oops. Avon couldn't make it there. Oh, wait, we were heading this way. Oh, we can't go that way. Mm. Thank you. Oh, found another? Nope. No, it doesn't want to fight us, so... We're not getting mad XP from these things, so... I'm not hell-bent on fighting them all this time. These will fight. Everyone, pile in the dragon! A little bit of magic. Just a little bit. Can't go up there? Okay. Oh, four of them? Wow. Magic. Spirit. Scotia. Water protectors, I call upon you for your help. Haha, awesome. Oh, that's pretty sweet. It one-shotted one of them, because one of them we had not damaged yet. Peaceful monster. Here we are, the Idun Shrine. Oh. Avon says, so this is the Idun Shrine. Where is Reithol? Ruti said, they said he should be training at the entrance to the shrine. Let's find him. Very slowly, apparently. A young man's voice says, I can't do that. I only sense an evil spirit from you. I can't take such a person into the shrine. What's that? Says Avon. Now that's a person. People are arguing over there, Ruti says. What are you doing? You're drawing my power out of me. Whoa! Something is wrong, says Lucius. Yeah, says Avon. Let's hurry. Oh, he's heading right over there, okay. Silver haired or purple hair? Maybe the silver hair was the one who ran in there. Wow, is he like trapped in there forever now or something? Avon says, look! Yeah, I saw it. The lid closed automatically. Ruti says, I feel an ominous air. Lucius says, Avon, Rutis. He is unconscious. We should treat him quickly. Is he Reithol? Says Avon. I think so, says Ruti's. I saw him in the revelation we had on the Truth Island. Let's go back to Garden Hill first. Oh. Avon carried unconscious Reithol on his back and took him to the Elder's house in Garden Hill. Alright. I wanted to look around the place, but it's not happening. Elder Rapan says, the injury doesn't seem serious. However, Reithol is an ascetic. He undergoes harsh training every day. To be honest, I can't believe he fainted. Well, someone drew all his power out of him, leaving him with, like, nothing or something. Avon says, when we came, Reithol was already lying there, and the entrance to the shrine was closing behind him, or beside him. Lucia says, this young man was arguing with someone. There must be other visitors besides us. According to the villagers, a young traveler came to Garden Hill other than you. They say he's a handsome young man with silver hair. A young man with silver hair, says Avon. I have a bad feeling about this, Ruti says. We should go back to the Idun Shrine and take a look. I also want you to go back. Idun is the important guardian god of Garden Hill. The If something happens to Idun, the village will be in great trouble. All right then, says Avon. We'll go and take a look once again. Oh, I almost forgot. Avon handed lunch to the elder. I don't think he can eat it now. Could you give it to Reithol when he comes to?
I will.
I forgot all about the lunch myself.
Avon, do be careful. Please protect Idun. By the way, I see you all are a little tired. Would you like to take a rest?
Sure.
Hurry up, but, you know, rest here for like 8 hours or something.
He's not saying anything, but... yeah. Do the other people here say new things now? Now that that happened? It's possible. I'm gonna fall in the water again.
My brother and Reithol are good friends. When I was a baby, the two went down and traveled around the lower world.
I see, says Avon. It's good to have childhood friends.
My dream is to travel around the lower world just like my brother and Reithol did. A man should have big dreams, right?
Yes, but you are not a man. You are a boy.
Mini maze almost.
Didn't say anything new.
The direct service elevator hasn't been working well lately. Merchandise sometimes doesn't arrive because of elevator malfunction, and we're troubled. The machine's old. I wonder if the elevator has reached its life.
No, the guy said he'd fix it, and I believe him. For some reason.
Just have a feeling it's gonna happen.
I'm gonna figure out how to get to the next place.
Oh.
Sorry, I got lost. Running on beds and stuff. This guy. I want to talk to him.
I used to work at a factory in Guia when young, so I have expert knowledge of machinery. That's why I'm in charge of the canyon elevator.
Well, you're not doing a very good job. Go fix it now. Face my wrath.
Garden Hill also has a festival dedicated to the spirit, although it's not as grand as the Idun festival they have in the lower world. We are home to the Idun Shrine, so ours is the original festival.
Okay. Well, it makes sense it's the god of wind here, because you definitely hear the wind, and feel it, I'm sure, wherever you go. Anybody else skulking about?
I didn't see her before. Oh, it's Malin. Reithol's injury doesn't seem serious. That means I must do something to prevent him from eating my sister's food and getting worse.
Ha! Well, you better go talk to the elder then, because the elder's gonna give it to him when he wakes up.
You willingly giving him bad lunch? Shame on you.
Oh. Oh, crap.
Greetings. Is it true Reithol got injured? I must visit him with my sister later. What should we do? What should we bring to an injured person for lunch? Oh. Well, we already gave him the lunch. That's her. They're the only two who live in this section, I guess. Alright, we're gonna follow this path again. Oh, fight monsters. Yeah, just kill it. I'll use the deadly or deadlies next time. Ooh, even getting close to level 29 and Tees as well. Yep, now we have to go back again. That thing. Kamikaze. Okay, you hit that, and we'll take care of these dragons. Oops. Didn't finish the dragon, what the hell? Gonna make it? Nope, not quite. Next time. Could've used a rarer there instead. I almost fought that thing instead. I was like, Greetings! We have come to kill you. We go. Aven, level 29. Tees, not quite. He needs 17 more experience points. Wow. So close, yet so far away. Never find out what that item was. Never. Alright. Deadly. Hope it's a one shot on this Dragon D over here. The rest of us will go for Dragon B. Sweet. How dare you singe my haircut? Alright, so B is damaged. And now dead. Tease, level 29, and she got Mind Shop? That's a strange name for something. Oh, ah! Couldn't wait for the battle's over. Mind Shop. Aims at an enemy's central nervous system, causing temporary panic. Interesting. Maybe someday I'll use some of this stuff. It's just, it always seems more effective to just hit them. And then heal up. Like, you can't run out of hitting. But you can run out of spells and stuff. Okay, I'm pretty sure up here is to the Idun Shrine. We'll be tackling that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.